Hello everyone, this is Mohammad Markodatil. Our topic for today is architecting data center using NSX and AVI load balancer. This been some time I posted any videos. Recently I worked on NSX-T and AVI integrations and thought to share that experience with you. Here are the few points I want to discuss today. The first thing, for the newbies, I want to introduce the solutions around NSX and AVI. Then we will talk more technical and understand how the solutions fit in a typical enterprise topology. Then we will conclude our discussions by looking into some of the key value proposition of the solution. Let's get started. To start with, both of the solutions, NSX-T and AVI load balancer, works on an SDN-based architecture. With SDN-based architecture, you have an SDN controller and you also have a data plane. SDN controller takes care of all your management aspects, configurations, policy definitions, operations, etc. When it comes to data plane, it makes sure it can process the traffic based on the policy it gets from the SDN controller. When it comes to NSX-T, the SDN controller is the NSX-T manager itself. And the data plane for NSX-T is VMware, ESXi-based hypervisor or KVM-based hypervisor. Now let's talk about AVI controller. AVI controller is the SDN controller for AVI solution. It takes care of all the ADC use cases, including load balancing, GSLB, WAF, etc. And AVI has a data plane component, which is called as service engine, that processes all those ADC related data. Now let's take a look at these two solutions from an architectural perspective. When you build an architecture, you need to make sure that the solutions can work together without introducing lots of complexities. And the architecture should be able to support scalability, high availability, and also you should be able to manage it in a very simplified way. The first thing is, if you look at, there is a group of servers, which is NSX-T manager, vSender, AVI controller. This all could be part of a management segment. And you can call them as element managers, since these controllers are managing your network and security infrastructure and also ADC infrastructure. If you take a look at NSX-T manager, it does logical routing component. It also does distributed firewalling and IDS IPS component. So routing, switching and IDS IPS functionalities taken care by NSX-T manager. And when it comes to AVI controller, it makes sure that in the topology, all the ADC related use cases are managed from its UI. And the data is processed on the data plane. So with AVI, AVI service engine process the data plane. Now we will look at these solutions from an enterprise grade network perspective. In an usual enterprise, you will have single or multi-site, and each of the site you will have different segments like production, development, you must be having a DMZ, and you also will have a management segment. Usually in the management segment, all your element managers will be there, like AAA servers, your SDN controllers, everything will be part of management segment. Now, if you look at production segment, in the production segment, you have production workload. Production workload will reach NSX-T T1 logical router for gateway services. NSX-T T1 provides first hop gateway for the server segment, and it can also connect to other L4, L7 appliances. Now, when the traffic needs to go out of the segment, it forwards the traffic to T0 router. The T0 will connect to outside physical firewalling or physical router based on your topology. And the similar kind of semantic follows for development as well. In development, you will have development servers, and that servers connects to NSX-T T1-4 gateway services, and the T1 takes the traffic out using NSX-T T0. Now, let's look at DMZ. In DMZ, your applications are published. That means you need to have very tight control in DMZ. For AVI, this is one of the prominent use cases. It can use its web application firewalling or WAF to protect the applications. It can also provide GSLB services so that your applications can be load balanced or load shared across multiple sites. And there is another interesting use cases. Maybe your business want to extend your services across multiple sites. How do you make sure your infrastructure is supporting this kind of use cases? For that, you can also make use of NSX-T Federation. Federation extend your security and network policies across multiple sites. It uses Geneve protocol and overlay-based routing so that you can also eliminate spanning tree or any kind of L2 loops. Now, it is a time to look at the use cases. First, use case 1. In this, we are talking about how the solutions, these two solutions, integrate networking and L4, L7 services. For this, I am highlighting NSX-T Manager and also all the related policy construct. If you look at NSX-T Logical T0 router, this is the one helping you to send the traffic out of your NSX-T domain. Then there is a NSX-T T1 router which connects to your server segment, and also it can connect to your L4, L7 service appliance. In this case, it is AVI service engine. Now, NSX-T also can manage your distributed firewall and IDS IPS from its SDN controller. And there is a tight integration between AVI and NSX-T. The integration means it is very simple. You just provide the IP address and credential of NSX-T to AVI controller. So the moment you do that, AVI will get to know all those network and security policy construct. So whenever you are defining real server group or when you are defining your virtual services, you can easily call those network and security policies appropriately. Now let's look at use case 2. With use case 2, I want to highlight the ADC use cases. Think about you yourself in a retail business, and you may see lots of seasonal traffic. Maybe because of Christmas or Eid, you will see lots of traffic, and you want to make sure that whenever this kind of on-demand request coming in to your network, your infrastructure is ready to serve those kind of requests on-demand basis. So with AVI, this can be addressed very easily. You can easily set a threshold saying the moment it uses 70 or 90% of its resources, it should be automatically scale out to a multiple service engine so it can receive all those traffic. And whenever the traffic goes back to normal, the system should be able to optimize by itself. It can go back to normal state as well. This use case is really useful for most of the business, especially nowadays, most of the business are running using internet. Now, how do you secure your applications? For that, AVI can easily help you with inserting a web application firewall into your virtual services. Now, one of the interesting things which I experienced, the security groups you defined on the NSX-T are available for use on the AVI as well. That means you don't need to again call all those real server IPs when you are defining or when you are mapping your real servers to the virtual services. The security groups are carrying those server details. So from the AVI, you can pull down the security groups you want, and that will be your real servers, and you can map it to the correct virtual services for the client request. Let's move on to the final use case. This is about end-to-end monitoring and visibility. The important fact is the application is the most valued asset in the business nowadays. You need to make sure that it runs very efficiently without troubling your business. So as an infrastructure administrator, you need to make sure that you understand all the factors affecting your application, such as what is the delay from your client traffic coming to your load balancer, from the load balancer to the server, and also to the applications. Maybe the application is responding slowly because there is some issue with the infrastructure. Maybe it could be related to your server, or maybe it could be related to your application itself. AVI gives a granular check and options to see in each and every hop what is the round trip time happening, what is the delays happening. So as a manager, you'll be able to easily find out where exactly the trouble is, where exactly the delay is happening, and you can focus on that specific segment and resolve the issues. Now let's talk about connection log analytics. With the connection log analytics, you will get to know your client in a better way. You will understand what is the type of browser it uses to send the request, whether it is a Firefox, Chrome, IE Explorer, what is the operating system it uses, whether it is Windows, iOS, and what type of traffic it is sending to. It is sending an HTTP request, SSL request, or some other type of TCP request. All these informations are readily available on the AVI, so you can derive your insight from those information very easily. Now let's focus on the infrastructure side. From NSX-T, you get to know your complete topology around your traffic. It tells you where exactly the source is connected, where exactly the destination is connected, and how is the traffic moving from source to destinations, hop by hop, with all those interface informations. And in case if the traffic is dropped because of a firewall issues or a routing issues, you will be able to find out. Very powerful solution. So with this, I want to conclude by saying, if you can integrate your network and security and ADC, it will really simplify your end-to-end deployment and management. And of course, these solutions are best fit in a VMware-based infrastructure, but it can also work with some of the physical bare metal services. You need to make sure that you are planning it properly. The capacity planning is done, resource requirement is analyzed, and also the compatibility, very important. Thank you so much for your time. Hope you enjoyed the session. Stay tuned. Thank you.